Hi, I'm Reverend Tom Kearns. Welcome to 333 Magic 9, where the tarot cards and astrology stars come together to help you. By combining the visual messages of the tarot and the energy of astrology, you can be prepared for the opportunities and challenges coming your way. I hope you will like this video and also press the little bell for notifications when my new videos come out. The tarot card for the first week of the month is the Fool. He represents a new journey or new beginning. The tarot card for the second week of the month is the Nine of Pentacles. She represents success and security. The tarot card for the third week of the month is the Queen of Cups. She represents compassion and healing. The tarot card for the final week of the month is the Wheel of Fortune. This card represents a positive change of events about to occur. Leo, the tarot card for the first week of the month is the Fool. It shows a young man who's beginning a journey. He is traveling with a staff over his shoulder that contains only the necessities that he needs. He is holding a rose in one hand, and next to him is a small dog who accompanies him on his journey. Since he's not looking where he's going, there may be some challenges ahead that he's not prepared for, but he travels on with faith and hope for the future. His small dog can represent the instincts that will guide him. Now, as we look into the astrology, the month begins with Mars in the ninth house, squared to Pluto in the sixth house of work and daily routine. Now, this powerful energy can bring focus to work and health issues. Make sure you keep control of your emotions, especially in work situations. Mercury in the 11th house of associates will square Neptune in your 8th house of passion. So this can cause confusion in intimate affairs and also in joint financial business deals. Mars enters Taurus and your 10th house of career at the end of the week. So take practical steps towards success. Mercury will move into Cancer, and this can help facilitate any type of investments or secret earning opportunities that may come your way. So listen very carefully. The tarot card for the second week of the month is the Nine of Pentacles. This card shows a woman standing alone in a lush garden. She's well-dressed and a falcon is on her hand. She represents a sense of accomplishment and security. She may also signify the ability to attract the good things in life. This is a positive card that suggests that some good things may be coming your way. Make sure you treat them with respect. The second week is exciting as the Sun and Mercury will sextile Uranus up in your 10th house, bringing opportunities to use your ideas to be more successful in your career. Venus will trine Saturn in your 7th house, and this can bring common sense help from business partners. So be prepared for a little success. But be a little bit careful at the end of the week when the emotional full moon will pit work responsibilities against your fears. Now, Venus in the 11th house squares Neptune up in the 8th house of shared energy and passion. So this can bring a state of confusion in personal issues. So don't let mistrust guide you. The tarot card for the third week of the month is the Queen of Cups. This is a positive energy and suggests healing and compassion. It may be a good time to offer support and forgiveness to someone in need. You have the creative ability
to deal with emotional issues, and you may be able to come out of a difficult situation smelling like a rose. Now, the third week begins with the Sun in the 12th house, trine Neptune in the 8th. This is a gentle energy that promises an increase in psychic awareness and even a sense of rebirth. Take some time to develop your deeper intuition and connect with others on a deeper level. The middle of the week becomes more challenging as the Sun and Mercury will oppose Pluto in the 6th house. Now, this may put you at odds between your need for quiet and renewal of your spirit and your work responsibilities. Tension must be avoided to maintain your health and well-being. The tarot card for the 4th week is the Wheel of Fortune. It depicts the 4 fixed signs of the zodiac, bringing a sense of spiritual continuity that lies behind the ever-changing nature of the world. This is a positive card and suggests that our fortunes are taking a turn for the better. In fact, you may be feeling that way already. So enjoy the cycles of life and be open to exciting new possibilities. Now, the 4th week is a week of challenge. Venus in the 12th house will square Jupiter in the 9th house, warning against disagreements over beliefs or values. Mercury in the 1st house will square both Mars and Uranus, and that warns you against aggressive and willful action in your career and in other social situations. Jupiter will turn retrograde in your 9th house, joining the new moon energy, and again suggesting a need to curb personal belief systems. Review your goals and your philosophy of life. And then Mercury will oppose Saturn to end the month on a serious note, suggesting you listen very carefully to your partner and their ideas. And be careful in public.
Hi, I'm Reverend Tom Kearns, and this is my story. If you are a spiritual seeker, it may help you on your journey. I believe your spiritual development is as important as your religion. If you look at Christianity, it focuses on the life of Jesus. But Jesus was never a Christian. He was Jewish. If this thought intrigues you, you'll enjoy my new book, Light from Water, Freeing Jesus. It's available on Amazon.com and through fine bookstores. And it may help you on your spiritual journey. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. Please like this video, subscribe, and ring the little bell to be notified when new videos come out. And if you'd like to arrange a private psychic and spiritual reading with astrology, just go to my website, internetpsychicreadings.com or professorastrology.com.